The Prince of Peace is coming. Emmanuel is coming. The
Only
One that Truth and Life is coming. Are you preparing to meet the Lord? Are you preparing to meet the King?
Those who don't belong will wonder where we've gone. Jesus is coming back again, the time is very near. Give your heart to Jesus now. Every knee shall bow, turn to Jesus.
Oh, no.
Oh, la gara lati We thank you because you are going to instruct us today. Thank you because you are going to prepare us for the coming tonight. Father, we send in that way something in Jesus' name. I love the prayer tonight. Take absolute control in Jesus' name. Thank you, faithful and Lord God. In Jesus Christ's name we are praying. And let everybody say, and let everybody say, have your seat. Have your seat. We have a very short time. But within this short time, I want us to listen to the word of God. I want you to listen carefully. I want you to listen carefully. I want you to listen attentively. Because the Lord has a message for all. Tonight we want to consider the topic that says thy king is coming. Thy king is coming. coming.
Oba re n bo wa.
Everybody shout, thy king is coming.
Oba re n bo wa.
I want you to shout louder, 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 louder.
Let your power new louder.
Thy king is coming.
Oba re n bo wa.
In the book of Revelation 22, Revelation 22, we want to read verse 7.
If you are orientated,
Revelation chapter 22, verse 7.
If you are orientated,
the Bible says, "Behold, I come quickly. Blessed is he that keepeth the same of the prophecy of this book." And now, if we look at this verse very well, and let's consider verse 12 unto 13. And behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me to give every man according as his work shall be.
Yes,
and the person that is coming declare his name in that verse 13, and he says, I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. Then let's consider verse 20. He which testified this day, say, surely I come quickly. Amen. Even so, come, Lord Jesus. Now, we are read in this place, we said, the Lord said, I am coming quickly. I am coming quickly. In a different place, the Lord said, I am coming quickly. If we consider the chapter 3, Revelation chapter 3, verse 11. Revelation chapter 3, verse 11. Bible says, behold, I come quickly. Hold that fast with thou heart, that no man take thy crown.
Yes, this is he.
Now the Lord is very sure of what he's saying. Therefore, he declared different places in this scripture that he is coming quickly. He doesn't say, I am coming slowly. He doesn't say, I will come maybe later on. But he said, I am coming quickly. The return of the Lord is alarming to the world. That is why the Lord is alarming, crying, trumpeting everywhere, repent and prepare the way, the Messiah is coming. Because the coming of the King is near, he is near, is at the door of the planet of the earth. Because I'm sure they said, if the Lord believes coming, we shall be able, we are going to do the next and invest. But yet, people are not preparing for the coming of the Lord. You have been hearing the Lord is coming, but are you preparing for his coming? Hope you are not ignorant of preparation for his coming. In different places in the scripture, the Lord declared, I am coming quickly. And he said, my reward is with me. My reward is with me. And if somebody said, I am coming quickly, it means I am coming rapidly. I am coming speedily. I am coming with rapid movement. That is, I don't want to delay. I want to come so quick, more than your expectation. That is, he is coming. He is full of assurance.
It's
just like when you are at the bus stop waiting for somebody and the person said, I am coming quickly now. And that proved that the person is coming and is sure of his coming. Coming quickly means coming without delay. Therefore, the Lord is coming for a divine purpose. The Lord is coming for divine purpose. He said, I come quickly and my reward is with me. He is coming to rapture the church of the Lord. He is coming, he is coming any moment from now. That is why I am crying to you tonight. Anywhere you are hearing me. The King is coming. The Lord is coming. The Lord is coming. With the host of angels.
They
are going to accomplish him. In this our very sky. The Lord is going to appear with a glorious garment, beautiful garment. Those that have Jesus in their lives as their Lord and personal Savior, they will be the one to see him and go with him. You
must
say, I have been hearing Jesus is coming a long time ago. Many years ago, they have been saying Jesus is coming and I don't see Jesus. Because of this, you have relapsed in your faith, you just go to church, but you still indulge in sin. You have to claim to have Jesus in your life, you carry Bible and yet you don't have salvation. I'm going to give you 5 proofs that shows that the coming of the Lord is so near to us. I'm going to tell you the certainty of the coming of the Lord. Because I'm very sure. In the revelation, the Lord appeared to me. And he told me, I am coming quickly. In the sky, I saw the finger of God writing, Thy King is coming. Any moment from now, the Savior of the Lord shall come. The King of Glory shall come. Are you preparing to meet the Lord? And how are you preparing to meet the Lord? Now let me go to my proof. What shows that the Lord is surely come? Because there's some prophecy in the Bible that was declared by the prophet and it came to pass. And if these 5 prophecies can come to pass, it will surely come to pass. Number one, the prophecy of the birth of Jesus Christ. Quickly open your Bible to the book of Isaiah 7 verse 14.
Continue with Isaiah 7 verse 14.
The Bible says, therefore the Lord himself shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel. Now chapter 9 verse 6. For unto us a child is born, and us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
things.
Nítorí àbí ọmọ kan fún wa, àfọmọkùnrin kan fún wa, ìjọba yóò sì wà ní èjìká rẹ̀, a ó sì máa pe orúkọ rẹ̀ ní ìyanu, olùdámọ̀ràn, ọlọ́run alágbára, bàbá ayérayé, ọmọ alájà
wàfíà. I really want to read this place and I'm going to explain to you the years that it takes before this prophecy came to pass.
Mo sọ ẹ́ka bí ìbàyẹ̀ wọ́n sì sọ fún wa, ọdún tí ó gbà, ọdún tí ó ná wa, èyí tó yẹ pé kàtó tẹ́lẹ̀ ló wá sí ìmúṣẹ.
Now in the book of Micah chapter 5:2.
Nínú ìwé Mika orí karùn-ún ẹsẹ̀ kejì.
Micah chapter 5:2. Ìwé
Mika orí karùn-ún ẹsẹ̀ kejì.
But thou Bethlehem Ephrata, though thou be little among the thousands of Judah, yet out of this shall he come forth unto me, that is to be the ruler in Israel, whose going forth have been from of old, from everlasting.
Ati iwo Bethlehem Ephrata, bi iwo ti je kekere laarin awon egbegberun Juda, ninu re ni eni ti yoo je olori ni Israel yoo ti jade toru wa, ijade lo re si je lati igbale ati ayeraye.
Now the first prophet that first spoke here.
Àsọtẹ́lẹ̀ àkọ́kọ́ wòlíì tó sọ̀rọ̀ níbi ìbàyẹ̀ àkọ́kọ́.
Isaiah declared the Lord is coming, a virgin is going to conceive and give birth to a child and his name shall be called Emmanuel.
Wòlíì Isaiah sọ wípé a ó bí ọmọkùnrin kan, a ó sì máa porúkọ rẹ̀ ní Emmanuel.
This prophecy came to pass after more than 700 years.
Àsọtẹ́lẹ̀ wá sí ìmúṣẹ lẹ́yìn ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ọdún 700 years sẹ́yìn.
After the prophecy, many people died.
Lẹ́yìn àsọtẹ́lẹ̀ yìí, ọ̀pọ̀ ènìyàn ló kú.
For this prophecy was written in the book of the law of the Lord.
Ṣùgbọ́n àsọtẹ́lẹ̀ yìí sínú ìwé òfin Olúwa.
And therefore this word is specially kept in the temple.
Nítorí náà àtọ́jú rẹ̀ sínú tẹ́ḿpìlì.
It's a very big, very very big.
Ó jẹ́ ìwé tí ó tóbi púpọ̀.
That unto us a child shall be born.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ sí wa o, a ó bí ọmọkùnrin
kan. This child is going to come out through a virgin.
Ọmọ yìí yóò wá láti wú ní obìnrin.
Imagine after more than 700 years.
Wọ́n náà wò lẹ́yìn ọdún 700.
And Prophet Micah.
Kò rí Mika yìí.
Now they cleared the real the savior will be born.
Ó wá sọ ibi táwọn ti bí olùgbàlà gangan.
And that was Bethlehem.
Ibi ìsìn ni Bethlehem o.
And this thing came to pass after 700 years.
Èyí sì wá sí ìmúṣẹ lẹ́yìn ọdún 700.
After 700 years.
Lẹ́yìn 700 ọdún.
And event now take place in the book of Matthew chapter 1:23.
Ìṣẹ̀lẹ̀ wá ṣẹlẹ̀ nínú ìwé Matthew orí kìíní ẹsẹ̀ kẹta.
Matthew chapter 1:23.
Matthew orí kìíní ẹsẹ̀ kẹta lẹ́yìn ogún.
Open your Bible to that place.
Ṣí sẹ́yìn rẹ̀ lọ síbẹ̀.
And behold, a virgin shall be with a child and shall bring forth the son, and they shall call his name what? Shout it loud and clear. I can't hear your voice. They shall call his name.
Kíyèsí wúndẹ́kọ̀ yóò lóyún yóò sì bí ọmọkùnrin kan, wọ́n máa pe orúkọ rẹ̀ ní Emmanuel.
And now this prophecy came to pass.
Àṣẹ́lẹ̀ wá wá sí ìmúṣẹ.
Number 2 proof.
Àrídájú ẹlẹ́kẹ̀ẹ́.
Fulfillment of the birth of Jesus Christ.
Ìmúṣẹ ìbí Jésù.
Number 2, fulfillment of the birth of Jesus Christ.
Ìmúṣẹ ti ìbí Jésù Kristì.
After 700 years.
Lẹ́yìn ọdún 700.
And this prophecy came to pass.
Àṣẹ́lẹ̀ wá wá sí ìmúṣẹ.
A virgin conceived.
Obìnrin kan yóò
yún. Conceived indeed.
Ó lóyún tòótọ́.
And they gave birth to Jesus Christ.
Wọ́n sì bí ọmọ náà ti ń
jẹ Jésù. And in that book of Matthew chapter 1.
Wẹ̀ Matthew orí kìíní náà.
If we read verse 18 and 24-25.
Wọ́n ká ẹsẹ̀ kejìdínlógún 24-25.
Let's read 24-25. Then Joseph being raised from sleep, as the angel of the Lord has buried him and took unto him his wife, and knew her not till she had brought forth her firstborn, and he called his name Jesus.
Nígbà tí Jésù dìde nínú oorun rẹ̀, ó sì bí áńgẹ́lì Olúwa tí ń wí fún un, ó sì mú aya rẹ̀ sí ọ̀dọ̀, òun kò sì mọ̀ títí ó fi bí àkọ́bí rẹ̀ ọmọkùnrin, ó sì pe orúkọ rẹ̀ ní Jésù.
Now I go to proof number 3.
Mo lọ sí àrídájú ẹlẹ́kẹta.
Death and resurrection of Jesus Christ.
Ikú àti àjínde ti Jésù Kristì.
Fulfillment of the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ.
Ìmúṣẹ ikú àti àjínde Jésù Kristì.
In the book of Isaiah chapter 53:2-12.
Nínú ìwé Isaiah orí kẹtàléní-àádọ́ta.
If you read that place declare how Jesus will be crucified.
Tábàtàbí yìí ó sọ fún wa bí a ó ti ṣe kan Jésù Kristì mọ́jà.
How we will be taken for one call what? From one prison to the other.
How is my mercy be adapted to the true life because you know?
How they are going to bruise him? How they are going to torment him?
Oh, shine your baby, oh, shine your jet.
And this prophecy came to pass.
So tell us you are seeing, Moshe.
After many years.
Then your father.
And when Jesus came, he said, I must go, because the Son of Man shall be hanged.
And
this prophecy came to pass. And then Luke 24, verse 2 to 6, he declared that Jesus arose from the dead.
You know, Luke, or you can lay your words and take a seat if I offer you a repair. Just within the last look,
I'm going to prove number 4. The remarkable ascension of Jesus Christ. After he finished talking with his disciples, there is a great incident that happened in the book of Acts, chapter 1.
Acts,
chapter 1. We want to consider verse 9 to 11. The Bible says, and when he had spoken these things, while they beheld, he was taken up, and a cloud received him out of their sight. And while they looked steadfastly towards heaven, as he went up, behold, two men stood by them in white apparel, which also said, you men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven? The same Jesus, which is taken up from you into heaven, shall so come in like manner as you have seen him go into heaven. Say amen. When Jesus finished discussing with his disciples, and after final greeting, he was received up to heaven. And the disciples, they began to look up, they began to gaze up. And as they were gazing up, something happened. Mighty angels of the Lord appeared. Why are you gazing up? Jesus has taken away from you. We come back again. That is the angel of God. And this is a great miracle. It's a remarkable thing in history. For the angels to appear in the sky and people see it. Different places in the scripture, the disciple says, we are a witness unto Christ. Even in our very presence, he was taken up to heaven. And the angels of God, they appeared and said, he is going to come back again. Proof number 5. Fulfillment of the prophecy of Jesus Christ. Fulfillment of the prophecy of Jesus Christ. Before Jesus was taken up, when he was with his disciples, they asked him, Master, what shall be the sign of your coming? In the book of Matthew 24, from 3 down, Jesus said, take heed that no man deceive you. Many shall come in my name and they shall deceive many. Nation shall rise against nation. Kingdom against kingdom. Because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold. Said there will be earthquake and pestilence in diverse places. And now this prophecy is coming to pass in our presence. Of we are the witness. Because we can see what is happening even within this country. One bit of church accident here and there, people fighting because of land. And have you not seen before people that have said, I am the owner of this land, I am the owner of this land, two families are beginning to fight each other.
Oh,
It's a false prophet, they shall run.
They
can see their church all around. Church in Kishin, church in Mimbia Palace, church in Kishin, different places. And lying people, deceiving people in the name of the Lord.
And
this prophecy is coming to pass in our very presence. Therefore, Jesus has said that is going to be the sign of his coming. Therefore, I am very sure that any moment from now, the trumpet shall sound. Because the revival of today has been declared many years ago from the mouth of Prophet John. Therefore, are you preparing to meet the King? When Jesus shall appear with you, go with him. Three points before we go into serious prayer. Three points to consider before we go into prayer. Point one, preparation to meet the King. Preparation to meet the King. Point number two, the tribulation of the land behind. Here I'm going to share what I saw about the great tribulation some week ago. Point number three, the King calling for repentance and holiness. The King called for repentance and holiness.
We're
going to point number one. Preparation to meet the King. In the book of Matthew 25:1-4. There's the kingdom of heaven be likened unto 10 virgins, which took their lamp and went forth to meet the bridegroom. And 5 of them were wise, and 5 were foolish. They that were foolish took their lamps and took no oil with them, but the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamps. There are two categories of people that we have in the church. And we have two categories of people in the world. The wise Christian and the foolish Christian. Remember this place, the said they were
virgin.
That means they were Christian.
They
have the Bible. They sing
hymns.
They give testimony. They pray offering and tongues. But yet they don't have true salvation in their
life.
They don't have assurance of salvation. They don't have intimate with the Holy Spirit. And yet they say Jesus is coming. I must go with him. I am going with him. When the president is coming to visit a particular town, there is a way the town is going to prepare. They are going to tighten everywhere. They are going to assign security. You make sure that nobody threw dustbin on the ground. Because the president must see that our town is very mean. These people, they are going to assign that arrangement for now. In order to wake up become the king.
Láti lè kí ọba káàbọ̀.
So that when the president shall come.
Nígbà tí ààrẹ bá ma wá dé.
The president is going to say, this time, I so much love your security. I love this. I love that recommendation.
Ààrẹ a máa bẹ̀ sí máa sọ ìgbóni yìí wọ́n pé ààrẹ yìí mo máa fẹ́ràn yín. Mo fẹ́ràn bí àwọn tó tó yín. Bẹ́ẹ̀ lọ.
When government is going to visit a particular village.
Bí gómìnà kan máa fẹ́ bẹ abúlé ìlú kan wò.
And send a letter across the king.
Tó wá fi ìwé ránṣẹ́ sí ọba ìlú náà.
I said, I am coming to visit your village next week.
Tó pé ọ̀sẹ̀ tó ń bọ̀, mò ń bẹ abúlé rẹ wò.
You know, immediately.
Mọ̀ lójú kan náà.
The king of that village is going to call those workers to the king. All of them are going to arrange. Oh, yeah, send trumpeter. Begin to announce it. The governor is coming to our village by next week. Make sure when you leave, you are living your life.
Ààrí pọ́pọ́ máa pẹ àwọn olóyèrè àtọwọ́ òṣìṣẹ́ rẹ̀ wípé ẹ̀rọ àwọn èèyàn káàkiri gbogbo ta rí dájú pé ibi gbogbo wà ní àmọ́ tónítónítóní pé ààrẹ ń bọ̀ wá ní ọ̀sẹ̀ tó ń bọ̀.
He is going to prepare greatly to welcome the governor.
Wọ́n á múra sílẹ̀ kọ́kọ́ láti lè kí gómìnà káàbọ̀.
Now the king of king is coming.
Báyìí ọba àwọn ọba wọn padà bọ̀ wá.
Olúwa
àwọn olúwa ń bọ̀ wá.
The prince of peace is coming.
Alájà lásán ń bọ̀ wá.
Emmanuel is coming.
Emmanuel ń bọ̀ wá.
The only word that truth and the life is coming.
Ọ̀nà kanṣo pẹ́rẹ́ òtítọ́ àti ìyẹn ń bọ̀ wá.
Are you preparing to meet the Lord?
Ṣé o múra sílẹ̀ láti pàdé Olúwa?
Are you preparing to meet the king?
Ṣé o múra sílẹ̀ láti pàdé ọba rẹ?
Do you know that the coming of the Lord is very certain?
Ǹjẹ́ mọ̀ pé bí bọ̀ wá Olúwa dájú tòótọ́?
Are you prepared at all?
Ṣùgbọ́n ṣé o rẹ̀ múra sílẹ̀ ṣá?
The Lord wants every you to prepare.
Olúwa fẹ́ kí gbogbo ọ̀dọ́ múra sílẹ̀.
The Lord wants every man to prepare.
Olúwa fẹ́ kí gbogbo ọkùnrin múra sílẹ̀.
The Lord wants every woman to prepare.
Olúwa fẹ́ kí gbogbo obìnrin múra sílẹ̀.
The Lord wants every pastor to prepare.
Olúwa fẹ́ kí gbogbo olùṣègùn tó múra sílẹ̀.
The Lord wants every village and town ruler to prepare.
Olúwa fẹ́ kí gbogbo àwọn adarí ìlú àti adarí abúlé kó múra sílẹ̀.
And the Lord wants every source to prepare.
Olúwa sì fẹ́ kí gbogbo ìjọ múra sílẹ̀.
Ìfẹ́ wọn kọ́ sí ẹjọ́.
Ìjọba yóò ṣe léjọ́ sílẹ̀.
Ìyá pásítọ̀ ìyẹjọ́.
Ọjọ́ ìṣẹ́jú tọjọ́ rẹ.
And you have not been announcing to your member our king is coming. Begin to do now.
Oh, wá àti ìbẹ̀rẹ̀ sí máa kígbe fún àwọn ọmọ ìjọ rẹ pé ọba wọn bọ̀ wá báyìí bá tètè máa bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí ṣe.
Because the Lord wants everybody to prepare for his coming.
Torí pé Olúwa kí gbogbo ìnáwó wọn sílẹ̀ dé gbígbọ́ rẹ̀.
And be ready for the trumpet sound.
Wọ́n sì gbàdí sílẹ̀ fún ìró ìpè.
Because in the twinkling of an eye.
Torí pé láàrin ìṣẹ́jú.
Any moment from now.
Ìgbàkúgbà síbẹ̀ tá wọ̀nyí.
The trumpet is going to sound.
Ìpè máa dún.
Very loud.
Láìpẹ́ ló rárá.
Very loud. And those that are in Christ.
Àwọn tó ń bẹ̀rù Kristi.
Holiness of Christ.
Tó ń bẹ̀rù wà mímú.
The uprightness of Christ.
Wọ́n lè wà láyà àti
Kristi. The glory of the Lord is still shining in their lives.
Olórí sì fa àrùn náà yé wọn.
They are going to hear the sound of the trumpet.
Wọ́n gbọ́ ohùn ìwá ìpè.
Two men shall be in the field, one shall be taking the other man.
Ènìyàn méjì yóò wà lórí pápá, àwọn ọmọ ọkọ àwọn òfin èkejì sílẹ̀.
So service will be going on as they are singing, as they are preaching, Sunday school teachers, the trumpet is going to sound.
Ìṣẹ́ máa lọ lọ́wọ́ nílé ìjọsìn bá ti ń kọrin bá ti ń wàásù ìpè yóò sì dùn.
And if the trumpet sound and meet you anywhere, will you go with the Lord?
Bí ìpè bá sì dùn tó ọgbà ní ibikíbi ìjọ máa bá Olúwa lọ.
Because the trumpet is going to sound suddenly.
Torí pé ìpè máa dún lójijì.
It's going to sound suddenly.
Yóò dùn ní òjijì.
The Bible said that day is going to catch you, it's going to catch Ashmel as a snail.
Bíbẹ̀ ni pé ọjọ́ ẹjọ́ bá àwọn ènìyàn gẹ́gẹ́ bí ohun ìdẹ́kun.
It is you are not even aware of.
Èyí tí o sì bẹ́ẹ̀ o ò tẹ̀ mọ́ tó bú ẹ máa ṣẹlẹ̀ rárá.
As you bring that morning devotion with your family, the trumpet may sound.
Bó ti ń gbàdúrà òórùn pẹ̀lú ìdílé rẹ ìpè sì dùn.
And as you are maybe working and doing something else, the trumpet may sound.
Bóyá bó tẹ̀sẹ̀ rí tó ń ṣiṣẹ́ àbó ṣe òun mìíràn ìpè sì dùn.
But I want to ask you.
Mo fẹ́ bí ẹ léèrè.
If the trumpet sound, will you go with the Lord?
Bí ìpè bá dùn jẹ́ máa bá Olúwa lọ.
The Lord is ready for the rapture.
Lórí pé Olúwa ti múra sílẹ̀ fún ìgbà.
The Lord is ready to rapture the saints.
Olúwa ti ṣe tẹ́lẹ̀ ti gba àwọn ìfẹ́lẹ̀
sókè. The Lord is ready to rapture the church.
Olúwa ti ṣe tẹ́lẹ̀ ti gba ìjọ rẹ̀ sókè.
Therefore he is sending this warning to everybody in this place and in all over Iraqo to prepare the way.
Nítorí náà ọ̀rọ̀ ìkìlọ̀ ránṣẹ́ sí gbogbo ènìyàn níbí yìí àti ní gbogbo àgbègbè Iraqo pé ẹ tún ọ̀nà Olúwa ṣe.
He's warning everywhere in all over the world to prepare.
Ó ń ṣe ìkìlọ̀ ní gbogbo àgbáńlá. Ayé mi pé ẹ múra sílẹ̀.
Because he's giving sight in all continents.
Torí pé ó ti wá fi àmì coming of the
Lord is an endow of the planet of the air.
You must prepare and
be ready. If you read down, it gives us the description of how this thing is going to happen. That is why in the summer of our Lord Jesus Christ, he said, remember lost wife.
Yes,
for the Lord said, it's going to be like that day of Lot and Noah. Then let's read verse 40. There shall two be in the field, the one shall be taken, and the other left. Two women shall be grieving, and the one shall be taken, and the other left. What therefore? For ye know not what hour the Lord doth come. The Lord said you should wash and pray. Because his coming is an enough. Because he can come anywhere from now. The Lord is coming to bring salvation unto his people.
for lati mu igbala fun awon ere oni ore.
And to the people that are waiting and preparing for his coming.
And so le to nlo to si mu se de people.
And this is a salvation from the rocks to come.
E si ni igbala ku la gbe biri ti bo wa.
Salvation from the great tribulation.
E igbala ku la gbe poju lati bo.
Salvation from the rocks of the devil.
E igbala ku lati ni ibinu ro to Satan.
Salvation from the rocks of demon.
E igbala ku la gbe ibinu we mi okoko e memo.
Salvation, salvation, salvation from the hand of terrifying spirit.
Igbala, igbala, ku na be gbogbo awon eme mo to ni ku nberu.
And all the doors that are preparing holiness will be able to go with the Lord.
Igbala to ti mo se ni le wa mi mo ni ko ni yo le ba Oluwa lo.
How are you preparing for the Lord?
Bawo lo ti mo se le be ba Oluwa.
Hope you are not backsliding.
Nje oko e ti pe yin da.
You are hot sometimes ago.
Igba ko ti gbono jojo yin.
Full of zeal and passion for God.
O ku ita ti kanu for Olorun.
Just to carry megaphone every morning shouting Jesus is coming.
Mo ma be gbogbo re le gbogbo wura be ah Jesus Christ n padabo wa.
All of a sudden you will.
Sugbon ma ti o fi dire mo re wesi.
All of a sudden you turn away from the Lord.
Ewo o ti ti loko te si pada ko le Oluwa.
Yo!
Yes,
the angels in heaven they shout the king is coming. The father said the king is coming.
Baba we pray Obambo wa.
He sent in heaven they said the king is coming.
Our Lord is coming. We pray Obambo wa.
The Lord himself is now saying now I am coming again.
Only one friend we pray a mimbo kokole keji.
But is your life telling people that Jesus is coming again?
Because say I hear one support when I pray just to Obambo wa.
The Lord is at the door of the end.
Only one friend is anybody aye.
He's about to open the doors of the end.
Oh, what a sea, let me.
And why he's about to close the door of grace and mercy.
Just fell a sea, let me. I know a warrior fair.
He's at the door of the end.
Oh, what a anybody aye.
To come in.
Let him run into
the end. What should I say?
What's the time? Let's show you.
He's about to close the door of mercy and grace.
Oh, fell a sea, let me. I know a warrior fair.
Salvation and repentance should be too late for the sinners and backsliders.
Igbala, oh, we look when I'm up.
And
are
you prepared to meet the Lord?
Well, so what say the people will do?
The reason why he is coming again.
There is the matter of
number
one.
So we go to point number two.
And there is the point number
two. But I want to take away the sin from this sinful world.
Hey, there is the point number one. Let's let him know our effect. Come on, are you ashamed?
You want to take away the sin?
Oh, my God, we are going to
call. We are going them out of this sinful world.
Oh, my God, come on, are you ashamed?
Because he is aware of what is about to bring up before the world.
You are
to take vengeance upon the wicked world.
Wicked world
that they are changing men to women. Some years ago that the women dress naked. Wicked world that they kill the apostle and evangelist of the Lord and set fire on them. Wicked world, they put gun on the missionary and they shoot them.
Therefore,
the Lord is coming to take vengeance upon this wicked world.
The
missionary that they have killed, they are crying in heaven. When are you going to avenge our blood upon the wicked one? And the Lord is coming to take vengeance upon this wicked
one.
And number three, to open door for the Christ tribulation to come in.
Let me see, let me see, let me put you in the one.
Oh, joy, then go, yole, yole, yole. Commanding soldier in Sajun, finally, can he on that day, pastor will cry and roll on the ground.
Oh, joy, yole, so that keep a fast, I'm a year, a little marathon.
Afa, we cry, we mourn, we cry bitterly and roll on the ground.
Afa, ma'am, we don't keep back.
This man is going to cry bitterly.
Baba, lawo actually she will just so
beautiful. Oh, my wish I have seen Jesus.
Ah, my wish I have seen Jesus.
Ah, my wish I have seen Jesus.
Ah, my wish I have seen Jesus.
I quickly go to point number two.
What is your connection?
Tribulation of the land behind.
My job, what do you say to see there?
Tribulation of the land behind.
My job, what do you say to see there?
Matthew 21:22.
Matthew,
Matthew 21, verse 22.
Matthew, oh, you can
call it. Bible says, and all things, whatsoever you shall ask in prayer. Okay, Matthew 21.
You were Matthew, oh, you can call it.
Matthew 21. We want to read those, we want to read the statistics.
Amaka ese kele di no butch.
Again, he sent other servant than the first, and they did unto them likewise.
Osi tola awo omodo, me not judge awo tishadu lo, osi shebe si wo gege.
And if you consider this place,
why you give me you won't
take this? So people as this, God has been sending people to the war.
What was it? Allah is doing what was
done
here.
But people never told them.
So now we don't take people what
they told them.
What power?
They despise them.
What power?
They don't listen to them.
Oh, boss, what are you?
Take away the gospel. I
don't
want to hear about Jesus.
No, let's talk about Jesus.
Let it go.
Let it go.
I don't want to hear. But my brother and sister.
She wanna go celebrate me.
My brother and she and sister.
I wanna go celebrate me.
Jesus is calling to repentance.
Yes, you can see the look weather.
In the revelation.
Let me know.
I saw something so fearful. In that revelation, I was coming from somewhere. And as I was coming from that place, and all of a sudden, I saw demons. They came out from under. When they came out from under, the next
level
I saw, they don't
tell
people anything. I don't know when they got their weapon.
No,
they
touch you. Oh, Java.
Yes,
please.
They began to torment people.
What's the thing? What are you?
They began to cut people.
What is he showing you?
They were cutting people like a meat.
One day when you're being wrong.
And it was very terrible.
One day when you're
wrong. And I was running.
I was running with some pastors.
But now I'm
sharing
with
them.
I was some brother.
I was
running, running.
I run.
They were vomiting fire from their mouth.
Why you not tell the lady?
As the point they were running.
No, you're so sorry.
They were vomiting fire like a dragon.
What? You not tell the big dragon?
And the fire is a liquid fire.
You not see that? You not the lady?
They put with men.
I will remind you. No.
And fell and cry.
What should keep it from?
They found no death.
Oh, Riku.
They found no death.
Oh, Riku.
As they were cutting people.
Cutting children.
Your name is going to appear.
Oh, look, I'm a follower.
They were cutting the brother.
What did you call?
And I saw Taufik.
Why did you call Taufik?
Taufik, that means he is a Muslim.
Oh, you must be Muslim.
Hear me loud and clear.
Let me die down.
If you are in any religion,
you
must not believe in Jesus Christ.
Yes, but you just Christ.
Repent now.
But you look for that.
Repent now.
Don't look for that.
The God, the Lord is coming.
Don't look for
the King is coming.
Abba,
he is coming.
Abba,
he's allowed in announcing this to you.
Oh, keep the Lord alive. He's your letter.
Repent from every false religion.
Don't look for the God.
That vision.
Let me run you.
I was running. And we were hiding in a dirty water.
How far come to the
in a dirty water.
You dirty?
All of a sudden, I saw some army.
Where are you?
They hold some people.
What do you call
them? Near their trousers. They use their trousers to carry them out.
What you they were soaking.
I was dragging them.
What you found the
move.
Am I not?
Move.
That's what you.
And then we were hiding.
It became after what I was
seeing. We now saw some people.
I was a phone call.
You are going to be the one to go to spy. Spy. Go and spy if those soldiers are coming.
Hello,
as those people they went to spy.
In
a very dirty water. Very, that water was smelling. But we stand inside the water. And we bow down.
I was terrible.
We bow down.
I terrible.
We don't want them to see our head.
Then
all of a sudden, and those army they saw us. They said, you are come out. There is no place you can run to, just come out. And we walk out gently.
Our daddy person.
And they took us to a place.
I'm gonna see because
that place is a very magnificent. I have never seen such a place on earth.
You see the baby, you know,
very big.
Oh, to the world.
And people from all over.
I want to people born
to line up.
What to Lorila?
Very huge people.
Oh, to the top.
Some people they face the side. Some people they face the side. Some people they were standing on up
seeing.
And I saw a man that stood in our middle. And
the
man was saying, I
don't think any sense. I'm not telling you.
How are you going to survive? life. If you don't eat for 3.5 years, I will not survive. If they throw you into boiling oil, will you scream?
Sure, the king is sitting
at your bed to receive the man.
Oh, my baby.
Let me tell you something.
Yes, so before.
The demons.
Our name
from the sea.
That's your cool.
The one.
Our
operating in the sky.
Don't make for the food.
The one.
At
operating in the air.
I don't believe I can't move.
The demon that is seen in all the darkness.
Our name, my mission. That's so simple.
They are going to come out.
Well, you're telling me.
Everybody, every ass is going to see them.
Don't bring them. Don't bring them.
And they will come to torment the world.
What's telling me? Let's pray.
And they are going to release wrath upon the world.
What's it? Why are you looking at you?
And this wrath that is going to happen.
A budget to us is selling you.
The tribulation.
A budget to be
done. He's going to be very, very fearful.
I said to Kufi Ben.
He's going to come suddenly.
So, why don't you judge you?
And Lord is coming.
Oh, Lord, see, power.
To release his wrath upon the world.
Like the stone blessed. So, yeah, yeah.
Why the devil is going to appear to release his wrath as well?
Big man, say, you know, my father. That is 2 billion. So, yeah, yeah.
He must be going to release their wrath as well.
Ah, well, man, but what 4 billion? So, yeah, yeah.
And there will be covenant of the Antichrist.
Yes, you are.
And they are going to be giving people the mark of unity.
One man for our enemy, Ami Shoko.
The mark of 666.
Ami Efa, Efa, Efa.
You cannot buy.
Oh, Lilira.
You cannot sell.
Oh, Lilita.
You cannot go anywhere.
Oh, Lilita, be giving.
Unless you receive the mark of the beast.
Because she put by Miracle.
And anybody that received the mark.
And you can show us it, Bami.
Every God that received the mark.
And you can show us it, Bami.
Such a person is doomed forever.
Oh, Lilita, what is it? The power to say,
such a person is doomed forever.
Oh, Lilita, what is it?
This tribulation.
It produces like
this sort of people that are going to witness it.
If I am met a new celebrity,
number one,
a cocoa,
disobedient Christian.
Christian, a life, bro.
These are the set of people.
In a way,
who do not need their self in the law of God.
You want to follow us, follow us, or follow us.
But allow themselves in sin.
To offer up by follow up, she did that.
Practice sin.
One day, she.
They know that sin is a sin.
One paper, it is.
When they involve in it,
one share.
They will not go into it.
One moment, let's see.
They are disobedient Christians.
They are under
the power of the reigning sin. They are willing servants of sin. Who deal the members of your body as instruments of unrighteousness. Who serve diverse laws. Who make provision for the laws to fulfill the laws thereof. Let no man deceive you with vain words. Don't deceive yourself with vain
talk.
Don't think that you're going to escape from the wrath to come if you are not ready for the law. If you're living in sin, your security are vain and groundless. Because when the Lord shall come, you are going to be among those that is going to witness the wrath of God. These are blasphemers, swearers, murderers, abortionists, those that speak ungodly
words,
blackmailers, they are scoffers, spreading negative information about people, such as proud and boasters, such as disobedient to parents, those that have pleasures in the world, more than the pleasures of the Lord.
You have believed the Lord,
such as liars, unfaithful, such as idle and slothful, such that live in envy and malice, such that give themselves to revenge and cannot forgive injury. All sinner and the children of disobedience. Upon whom the wrath is coming.
Number two.
This wrath is coming upon the hypocrite Christian. They shall be punished terribly. These are the people that have the name
that
living. They have the title of a Christian. They are a prostitute. They are going to witness a great tribulation.
Oh,
these are the people.
Union.
They have the form of godliness.
To only irisi wapiona.
But deny them power they are.
Oh, si abanati benure.
They have the form of meekness.
When they irisi ne oni wapele.
But they are proud in their heart.
Oh, who is better than you?
Having the form of sanctified believer.
When they irisi oni wapoda ni sodi mo.
But have those been high.
When they okwedi ba ya kopati ato.
Having the form of holiness.
When they iri oni to be wapoda ni mo.
But they are sinful and corrupt.
Oh, she lets ya tell you to kufi di ba ya
kopati ato. These are the people that show some outward reformation. Without inward transformation, their heart is so rotten. These are the people that is going to witness a great revelation. These are the people that appear so committed. But take no time to be righteous. They
don't
live a holy life. They are quiet in their talk. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. But yet they are full of indigence. Their sin is most offensive to God. They have the title of a pastor, but they don't have transformation in their life. They are going to witness a great revelation.
Oh, sheleri, but you simple one.
Number three, impenitent and unbelieving people. These are the people that do not accept the gospel of the Lord. Such with God render to indignation and tribulation and anguish. Christ is going to come in form of flame of fire to take vengeance on them. These are the people that make the salvation of their soul. They are sinning against the only means to escape from the wrath of God. They are going to witness more than hell on earth. And this road is going to fully come on
down.
Because on that day, stars is going to fall upon the
world.
New stone is going to fall upon the
world.
God is going to release frogs to torment the world. Rock to torment the world.
Hey,
that day will be very terrible. As God is tormenting people, they must also be tormenting people. Satan also be tormenting people. And that day, where shall you be?
When
demons shall come out.
You are
workers in your
job.
You are a pastor. Sunday school teacher. Haven't you heard that Jesus is away? They will not ask any other question that to be tormented them.
Oh, ni bere bere juro, ni bere kocha down lolo.
That's when the Lord is calling us tonight.
Hey, ni lari alu apewa.
We will bind and prepare the way.
Koni kwa dako si chono no wa she.
Point number three.
Kope ne keta.
The king come for repentance and holiness.
Be apa fulo ni kwa da atiwa
bima. The king forward for repentance and holiness.
Be apa fulo ni kwa da atiwa bima.
God is calling every youth to repentance.
Amen. Repent to God. Do see ni kwa da.
To repent and live a holy life.
Atiwa ni kwa da kope bima bima.
God is calling every man, God is calling every woman to repentance and holiness. The Lord is calling the church to holiness. The Lord is calling the people of this land to holiness. To repent and prepare the way for the coming of the Lord. The Lord is calling everybody unto repentance. Repentance from idolatry. Repent from ungodly dressing. Ungodly doctrine.
Listen
to be baffled for women.
To
be going to river to take bath. To be using candle. To be using soap for prayer. Anointing oil for prayer. The Lord is calling to turn away from idolatry. and false doctrine.
But when we are not even coming in shape, we shall share as quite
God is calling you from the fashion of this world.
But when we are not coming in fire,
from the fashion of this world.
But when we are coming in fire,
repentance from every religion that does not proclaim Jesus as the way, the truth, and the life.
But when we are coming in fire, just suggest you are not to that.
He is calling every woman to dress holy to meet him in the sky.
Woman
that has still put on attachment.
Oh, very attached attachment.
She still put on trousers as a woman.
Oh, she was about to be very.
You still put on earring as a woman.
Oh, she was out there. She
put on a tight clothes.
As you don't want to come back.
Just put your underwear.
Okay, I will tell her.
You put on, show me your back.
Oh, to see a year for me.
Show me your breast.
See a bear for me.
Show me your lap.
See the letter for me.
Show me this, show me that.
I don't
want you to
live
back. Because if you dress that way, you cannot go with the
law.
The Lord wants every man to repent from ungodly dressing.
God wants your heart to be pure. God wants your dressing to be holy. God wants you to be sanctified. He wants you to serve Him and worship Him in spirit and in truth and in complete holiness. For without this, you cannot see the Lord. Without you doing the necessary restitution, you cannot see the Lord. Your tongue must be free from speaking deceit. Your heart must be free from taking bribe. God wants you to live in complete holiness. For without this, you cannot go with the rapture. You must be baptized in the Holy Ghost. For this will enable you to live a victorious Christian life. Join the Overcomer's Bride of Christ as you are going to listen to the word that is going to prepare you completely for the rapture. Join us and the Lord, who is able to do all things, will sanctify you wholly and prepare you unto His coming. Live a godly life. Live as saints in this world of sin. Be blessed with this message. It's going to help your walk with the Lord. You will never regret knowing this message. For this message will save your soul. It's going to deliver you from the power of sin. It's going to deliver you from the power of darkness. For this will help you and encourage you and help you in your journey to heaven.
Don't be the only one to listen to this message. Share it with your friend. Share it with your family. Share it in your church. and revive your church for the Lord. For you know that the day of the Lord is at hand, and the Lord shall come like a thief in the night. On that glorious day, only those that live in holiness within, holiness without, holiness in language, holiness in character, holiness in behavior, holiness in dressing, holiness in the heart will be able to go with the Lord. Prepare for the Lord today. Put on the whole armor of the Lord. Take time to study your Bible, and the God of peace shall help you in your journey to heaven. Join the Overcomers Bride of Christ Worldwide Ministry as you are going to listen to the message that is going to help your walk with the Lord. And it's my earnest prayer for you that God is going to open your spiritual insight so that you will see the things of the Spirit, and the Lord will be with you in the name of Jesus Christ. Be blessed with this message in Jesus' name.